Chapter 9, Application of Integration. The first headline is Riemann's Integration. Okay. So, what is the integration? Integration is the antiderivative of the antiderivatives. So, the reciprocal of the derivation, that is called the reciprocal of integration, differentiation, it is called integration. Okay. So, next one, Riemann's Integration. So, Riemann's Integration split up to three parts. The first part is left end rule, next one right end rule, next one midpoint rule. There is a three formulas. The first left end rule, integral a to b. What is the integral? This one a to b means that is the definite integral. So it is not given that to limit value. That integration is called to definite integral and indefinite integral. Okay, well, this one is going to definite integral. Next one, indefinite integral. Limit illa appadina adu indefinite integral. Limit irundhuchu adu definite integral. So a to b f of x dx equal to limit n tends to infinity maximum of xi minus xi n minus 1. So summation I varies from 1 to n in summation f of into xi minus 1 into xi minus xi minus 1. So the first one. So the sum of the terms, that is the left end rule by using for this formula, S is equal to this one. This one should be same formula. So S of into S equal to F of X naught, F of X1, F of X2 plus X and so etc. So F of Xn minus 1 into delta X. So delta X is the moving point, that is called delta X, that is equal to B minus A divided by N. B minus A divided by N. So next one, right end rule, integral a to b f of x dx equal to limit integral of limit n tends to infinity maximum of xi minus xi n minus 1 in summation I varies from 1 to n into f of xi. So this is xi minus 1, this is xi only. So remaining should be same. So next one, s of into f of this one f of naught, f of x naught, this one f of x1, f of x2 and so etc. f of xn into delta x, where delta x that is equal to b by b minus a divided by n. N means the total number of the element. That is called, this is the n, the limit value. So next one, the last one, midpoint of the rule. That is the midpoint of the rule is integral a to b f of x dx that is equal to limit n tends to maximum of xi minus xi tends to xi tends to xni x I minus 1 summation of I raised to 1 to n f of into x of xi minus 1 plus xi divided by 2. Next, xi minus xi minus 1. That's all. So, the other form of the midpoint end rule is equal to f of x0 plus x1 divided by 2 plus into f of into x1 plus x2 divided by 2 plus and so etc. into xn minus 1 plus xn divided by 2 into delta x. That delta x that is equal to b minus a. That is the Riemann's integration of the three part, the first part by using for the formula for this one, next to this one, next to this one. So three formula only. This is one of the form. This is also one of the form. Okay, both of them same formula only. So by using the formula for second terms, the regular terms only by using the formula. Okay, ma. In general, integration about your general discussion already integration we studied for the 11th standard integration is clearly for many formulas coming. 11th standard fully is integrated by indefinite integral. That is called no limit value integration only. So for 12th standard fully first sum onwards the definite integral. Okay, ma. So that is called y is equal to f of x. Y is equal to f of x means that is the general form of the function. This one the general form of the function. Okay. So next one, y is equal to x power n. So differentiate with respect to x, that is called dy divided by dx is equal to n into x power n minus 1. That is the differentiation. Next, integral of x power n into dx, that is equal to x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus c. That is the integration, x power n integration. So this one the same formula. Okay, ma. Y is equal to, that is a, this operator of this term means d by dx of into y, that is the operator. That is d by dx of x power n. This one integral of x power n. So this one should be function. The remainder d by dx is operator. Next, the simple and the dx is also operator. So this is called a sum. That is integral means this is called the sum of the terms. Appa sum of the terms into this one differentiation. Different of the terms will be cancels equal to x. Okay, one. So integration பத்தி என்ன நிறைய நம்ம டிஸ்கஸ் பண்ணோம். அது இன்டகிரேஷன் டிஃபரன்ஷியேஷன் ரிலேஷன் போட்டோம்னா தான் நம்ம கண்டிப்பா இது பத்தி நிறைய டிஃபரன்ஸ் நிறைய டிஃபரன்ஸ் நமக்கு கிடைச்சோம். இன்டகிரேஷன்னா டிஃபரன்ஷியேஷன் ரெண்டுமே ரிலேஷன் பண்றது இருக்கு. இந்த பிளஸ் சி எம் போட்டோம் பிளஸ் இதுல எதுவது சி வருது அப்படின்னு சொல்லி கண்டுபிடிக்கிறோம்னா அது தனி வீடியோ தான் போட முடியும். சோ இந்த டாபிக் பொறுத்துல ரீமான்ஸ் இன்டகிரேஷன்ல ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஃபார்முலா செகண்ட் ஃபார்முலா தேர்ட் ஃபார்முலா இதை நம்ம டிஸ்கஸ் பண்ணலாம். சோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஃபார்முலா எஸ்ல இருக்கு. சோ ரெண்டுமே ஒரே ஃபார்முலா எஸ்ல ஒன்னு எஸ்ல ஒன்னு இந்த எஸ்ல இருக்க ஃபார்முலா மட்டும் தான் நம்ம யூஸ் பண்றோம். சோ இந்த இடத்துல லெஃப்ட் னு யூஸ் பண்றப்ப நாட் வச்சு யூஸ் பண்ற ரைட் னு யூஸ் பண்றப்ப x1 அப்டினா இது 0 ல ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணுது இது x1 ல ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணுது ஓகேவா. சோ இத பொறுத்தல எல்லாத்துக்கும் மிட் பாயிண்ட் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணனும். சோ 0 ல இருந்து 1 வரைக்கும்னா 1 ல இருந்து 2 வரைக்கும் 2 to 3 3 to 4 4 to 5 and so on etc. தட் இஸ் தி ரீமான்ஸ் இன்டகிரேஷன். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கட்லைன் செகண்ட் கட்லைன் ரெண்டுமே ஈஸி தான். சோ 9.3 க்கு அப்புறம் தான் நமக்கான சம்மே நமக்கு ஸ்டார்ட் ஆகும் ஓகேவா.